You are now tuned into Calso Scoped.
What's going on YouTube? It's Calso Scoped, back for another video. If you guys don't know me, I'm a sports artist, currently with the UConn Huskies. In this video today, you're gonna be getting a breakdown of my Lonzo Ball poster design that I did the other day. So let's not waste any time getting to the breakdown. But before the video starts, I wanna show you guys three key things that really helped me throughout this piece. So to create a clipping mask, all you're gonna really have to do is add a new layer. And with this layer, you can right click on that layer. So you could right click, and then there's the create clipping mask right here. Then you could just choose whatever color that you would like to paint on there. And it's just gonna make sure that nothing goes outside of that box. The other shortcut to make a clipping mask is to just go right underneath the layer. Say if I don't have a clipping mask yet, go right underneath the layer. You're gonna hold down Alt, or it will be Command on the Mac. And you're just gonna click once you see this diagram right here. And this is gonna create a clipping mask like that. The concept art brush pack, which you see, which features the hairbrush that I use in this video, will be linked down below. So no hassle, just have to download that link. So you guys probably know how to make a layer mask, but I don't know if you know how to invert it. It's simple as well. So if I were to add a layer mask with this icon right here, and then I invert it, I would press Control I, and that would invert the mask. Now bringing back this mask, you'd have to paint on white, because black is going to hide on a layer mask and white reveals. So if I paint white right here, this will bring back the actual subject or mask. All right, those are some of the key shortcuts I use. Let's get to the breakdown. The first thing that I did on this composition was get all my layer mask and just all my masks together on the composition in the way that I wanted to make this poster. The second thing I went ahead and got done was getting on Topaz Labs. I just used Topaz Labs Crisp. I just used Crisp on this. And you guys know about Topaz. If you don't have it, I have a video on it to get it. Then I used selective color to get all the colors matching, and I wanted to make sure that just the mask was popping and just looked really good. So I just went ahead and used that, and then also I desaturated the whites on the jersey. This gives it a cleaner look when you're doing a poster design, or really any design. So I just did that for all of the masks, and I really just did the same things for all of the masks because you wanna just keep them unison and looking sharp together. I then went in, and you see me, I'm making half of this composition one color and half the other color. I went in and added a sky later, but you guys will see that. And I also did some hair masking with that concept art brush pack I just showed you guys in the beginning of the video. And I just went in on my mask and made sure that they looked really clean before I really got into it. Now I'm taking care of the highlights and shadows. I really like to boost the highlights and the shadows on my subjects when I'm making any type of design or artwork. It just gives it that pop without even Topaz Labs. It gives it a nice pop. I put in the ZO text, the ZO2 text, just to give that nice feel to the other side of the composition that I knew that I wasn't going to be using any type of sky. So I didn't want to leave it just like naked in a sense. I then loaded in my United Center photo. You guys are gonna see later that I pretty much just used the photo as it is and just adjusted the levels a little bit, but I wanted to put it inside of the jersey just to give this poster design a different element. I then matched my text colors because the red wasn't matching with the jersey color yet, and it's a little bit more pink. I noticed the Chicago red, so I went in and matched that. I then went to my Nebula sky that I wanted to use. I just looked it up on Unsplash. It's called Nebula if you search that. And I used this sky, and I wanted it to be blue because I wanted to contrast the red with a nice blue. Now you see me working on the exposure of this mask. And the reason I'm doing this is to get more of a highlight going so that I can do some nice rim lighting on the side of the mask, and that makes it really pop and look integrated with the actual poster. I used some smoke brush from the concept art brush pack on Linear Dodge. This allowed me to really boost some highlights on there and just make this thing really start coming to life. On the foot, I used some shadowing just to show that this 3D text is really in the composition. So all I really did was add a black layer and put on some black paint. I then like to always add some brightness to the eyes, and I do that to all three of the masks. And I also was contemplating what I wanted to do with the jersey, so I just was playing around with that for a little bit. And don't ever be afraid to just adjust as you're making a composition. Don't think that I just went through one shot and did this all just like as it is. So this is where you see I'm doing the highlights, and the highlights are really fun. I have a tutorial, I'll link that, so that you guys can know how I do the highlights. But I just did it on the left side where the sky will be interacting, and I think this looks pretty sick the way that I have started doing my highlights, and I think that you guys will appreciate that video if you haven't checked it out. But this is just a really fun part of it, and doing the highlights can really start making it come together. And once again, I'm just going back and adjusting things as I see fit along the composition. Like I said, man, really stress it. You're gonna have to be tweaking a lot, and don't think that like when people make these compositions they're not going back and tweaking them. Like, people make videos and make it look like they're not, but they are. So here, yeah, I'm doing a little bit of overlay on the lighting just to get that integrated, because you can't only have the outside lights, you have to have something that bounces off of that. And then this is just a little bit of haze that's going on that blue lighting from Lonzo, and this is gonna make it look even more like, you know, dynamic or realistic, whatever the case is. And I also wanted to add a little bit of glow on the 3D text as well. I think it turned out pretty cool adding that glow there, and I'm definitely glad that I did that. And I also added haze. So yeah, really doing composition work, you're gonna be doing a lot of the same steps. So I add a little bit of white glow actually on the right side, and this integrated him with the white background now. Now you're gonna see me creating the Photoshop square, and this square was really fun to make. I just really looked at the transform tool and then mimicked what it is. So I just added literally just added a cube, and then I added some white squares on the outside here. Simple enough, nothing too crazy. White squares with a small blue stroke. And then I just chose a selection from the nebulous sky and filled that square in for his eye. At this point, this is just gonna be a little bit of a speed art breakdown of what I'm doing. So I'll let you guys enjoy that real quick. So what you guys are gonna see right here is just me going in and doing a lot of my CCs, my color corrections, and my color lookups that I might use. Just bringing everything together, and even going into Camera Raw. It's really just the vital point of the edit and when you start to wrap things up. So to do this 3D effect that you guys are about to see right after some of this plays, all you have to do is just select your layer like you see right here, and then you're going to choose one channel and move that over to the left or the right, and then just bring the channels back. And this is going to actually create a 3D effect that you see probably a lot of times on Instagram. And if you've been confused, I have a video for that as well. At this point, there's the last step, just adding the rocks. It was simple enough, just add the rocks on the background on soft light. Soft light or overlay will work just fine here. I noticed later on that I actually had it on overlay, and I erased any that were on the mask. And then in the front of the scene, you're gonna see that I just matched them and made them a little bit lighter in the front than towards the back, because, you know, with the lighting up front there, they're gonna be more bright getting hit from the front. And then I just blurred them out to give that sense of depth to the composition. Thank you guys for tuning into this video. I hope you learned something through this process. And if you guys want specific tutorials on anything that I did, let me know down below, because I wanna start getting more of a consensus of what you guys really wanna see. With that being said, you guys can check out the full project file on my Patreon down below. I appreciate all the support, the shares, the subscribes. Thanks, guys. And until next video, stay scoped. Trying to gas me up, but she could barely move the needle. Hoppers always hating cause they trying to do what we do. I know I'ma make it cause I need to. Feeling like Sean, I'm the dumb.